Slopestyle is a combination of big air and gnarly tricks. And Team USA showed us they kind of like this event. I'm in Tempe at A Mountain, and as you can see behind me, the age-old battle is still raging between ASU and U of A. Get your tissues out because the Olympic Games are coming to an end this weekend. But before you do that, you might want to use a few now because Team USA watched a gold medal slip out of their reach. I'm here at Mesa Riverview, the Chicago Cubs' new spring training facility, and the Cubbies got to soak in their first game in the new stadium. But let's take a look at your picks and see how they did. Spoiler alert, some of you might be in trouble. Thanks, Nam, here at the U.S. Airways Center, the home of the Phoenix Suns, and they are off to a blazing start. But last night, didn't end too well. The Phoenix Coyotes are sending a franchise record 5 players to the Olympic Games. And 4 of them will be representing their country for the first time since joining the NHL. Point guard Eric Bledsoe just acquired in a trade in July from the Los Angeles Clippers, and now the two parties are talking money. But surprise, the American and Canadian clash on the ice is not over. NASCAR fans are in heaven this week as the Sprint Cup Series takes a turn into the desert. We're here at Salt River Fields, and as you can see behind me, the fall baseball season has already begun. Since slopestyle is a new Olympic sport, I do have to keep that in mind, but come on, we just turned the red, white, and blue into the gold, silver, and bronze. I give it a perfect 10. It's been almost 100 years since the Red Sox clinched the World Series at home, but the times, they are a-changing, and they're partying in Beantown, or should we say Beardtown, like it's 1918. What's a game highlight without a home run? I like it when you call me Big Poppy. David Ortiz with a 400-foot blast. That's the ball game, folks. Okay, time for some Portland highlights, or not. Marcus Morris steals the ball, that one to Goran Dragic, all by myself. Slam City Phoenix would go on to win 104-91. They are the best sand volleyball team in the country. And the women of Troy have the world's best player on their coaching staff, Misty May Trainer.
It's funny taking the coach role. I tell the parents, they're like, hey, coach. I'm like, that makes me feel old. Just call me Misty.
Okay, how about 3-time gold medalist? But her days competing with her teammate, Carrie Walsh, are behind her. Now, Misty is a part of a different dynamic duo on the sidelines with Anna Collier.
She was an incredible athlete. So sometimes that doesn't always transfer, but having worked with her and having known her mother and Misty most of her life, I was pretty confident that that was gonna be a smooth transition for her.
Don't pull on me.
She helped Carrie and I our first year together. I would like to call her a drill sergeant because that's kind of how she runs things.
The player who inspired a generation of girls on the world stage is now helping them improve their game in person.
Misty is unbelievable. She was my idol since I was 8 years old. So actually having her come in like as a coach, I was a little starstruck at first, I'm not gonna lie.
Misty wants sand volleyball to grow, and the women of Troy are setting and spiking the sport all the way to the top.
Coach, everybody's like, do you miss competing? I'm like, no, I play for fun. But to me, coaching is so much more rewarding and I love it.
No matter what, sand will always be Misty's home. On the beach in Santa Monica, Nick Marek, Cronkite Sports. It's dodgeball with a twist. Or should we say an extra jump?
There are NFL players dodgeball and we're at Sky Zone.
Birthday boy Kyle and his friends were busy beating 2 former athletes on trampolines. Quick feet and a little shake and bake wasn't enough to avoid the kids' deadly accuracy.
How many times did you get the NFL guys out?
Probably like 5 times.
Pro to You is a business where you can actually hang out and maybe play a game or two with some former pros.
We just created a platform where we allow the athletes to be able to be more accessible in the communities, have a little fun in the interim.
Former Arizona Cardinal and ProDU President John Bronson says while the kids get new playmates, they also get some real life lessons that could help down the road.
Push and drive to do whatever they want to do. It doesn't mean they have to be a professional athlete, but just be like, man, you know, if that guy can do it, you know, I can do it.
It's like the perfect family. The parents are happy, the kids are smiling, and the big brothers are exhausted. But what's a family without a little smack talk?
Get off the field.
No matter what sport, no matter how talented, they are all considered teammates. Bouncing in Peoria, Nick Marek, Cronkite Sports. The NFL settled with former players on a concussion lawsuit worth $765 million. But professional athletes are not the only ones who suffer from the risks of concussions. Whew.
They had to talk into my thick skull that your son actually was hurt, and it's serious.
John Hammonds and his son Judah did not spend the preseason on the football field this year.
But he had this really bad headache, you know, and he was holding his head like this. And
that's because in his final game last year, Judah suffered a head injury.
How did you feel when they told you you can't play anymore in that game against the Bandits? It was pretty sad.
A little bit faster.
So now, instead of putting on his uniform, doctors are making him do a baseline test after confirming he had a concussion. Judah has to pass the test before getting back on the field. And this is the kind of preventive medicine that needs to happen before kids put on their pads.
Good job.
The thing that you want to do the most at the young level is make sure that the foundation and the fundamentals of football are there.
Come through, club and rip, club and rip, club and rip.
Also, the Arizona Intergalactic Association announced a new contact rule for high school sports.
Good, nice.
During the regular season, football players can only participate in full contact for one-third of the practice.
Lean out, there you go, nice job, nice job.
A 2012 study by the AIA showed that one-third of all high school sport concussions happened during practice. Mountain Ridge's head football coach Bobby Green thinks this new non-contact rule may go nationwide.
Too tall, too tall.
I think it's something that is here to stay, and ultimately it's about athletes' protection and safety.
Hammond is still supportive of his son playing high school football, and he just wants Judah to be safe.
There's risk in football, we all know it, but on the other hand, we want to keep our kids safe.
Safe and happy. The madness is already beginning and the fans have their eyes glued to the games around me. And you have to check out, there's two upset alerts, both 12-seeded NC State and 10th-seeded St. Joe's. It's going to be intense. But let's take a look at your picks and see how they did. Spoiler alert, some of you might be in trouble. In the first game of the day, Dayton soars over Ohio State with a bucket in the final seconds. It was the kiss that rocked Dayton. They win the nail biter 60-59. Want another upset? We got it. If you picked Harvard as your 12-over-5 upset, you win. Harvard knocks off Cincinnati 61-57 as Rivard set the school record for three-pointers made in his career, and he will face Michigan State on Saturday. Couple of close games, but here's a blowout. It was close for the first 10 minutes, then the Badgers went on a tear. Wisconsin smoked American University 75-35. Ouch. Wisconsin's Trayvon Jackson led all scorers with 18 points. But the game I'm most forward to looking at is the Sun Devil Longhorn game. Hopefully Jihee Carson can put that brutal Pac-12 tournament in the past and grab hold of the horns. Tip-off set for 6:40 p.m. Now let's step aside from the madness and head down and see how the Suns took control of their game last night. Tensions were high early, but the Suns didn't phase them. The Bash Brothers connect with an alley-oop, Marcus to Markieff Morris. They did that a few times in their driveway growing up. And here comes the dagger, Gerald Green, silky smooth from three. One of his 4 three-pointers he drained. Suns go on to win 109-91. Folks, enjoy the full weekend of March Madness and best of luck to all of your brackets. But for me, I got to step aside. This NC State game's really looking good. An 8-point lead for the Wolfpack. Also, St. Joe's up by 5.5. Guys, you're going to want to see this.
Thanks for that report, Nick. I know we're all looking forward to watching some good basketball games after this.
I am too.
Absolutely. Great, thanks.